today?
Hello again, everybody.
Oh, Harry. Harry. Oh, yeah, Harry.
You know, there comes a time when you probably ought to stop broadcasting. I probably should have quit about 5 years before I passed.
Yeah. I think we should have quit about 20 years ago.
That's okay. I've been listening since 10. I can't make anything out of it.
What am I, an accountant? What do I know?
We only deal in truth here.
Oh, my God. What world am I living in? Scott Martin's making me laugh.
Don't you feel a little stupid? Go over there this afternoon. Throw your worm in the water and see how that works out.
Throw your worm in the water means something different in Los Angeles.
Well, it means about the same thing here in Kenosha.
Wow.
Things haven't changed.
That's what I'm saying. I can't make heads or tails. Which part is which?
Was a virgin sacrifice?
Not that I recall. We couldn't find one.
And not in Kenosha anyway, right?
Get through what you got to get through, Scott.
This program is a real challenge.
Good morning, everybody. This is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the February 23rd edition of the award-winning Kenosha Today Weekly Report. I am bringing you greetings from President Donald Trump.
Okay.
That's about the same reaction that the Vice President got this week. Anyway, coming to you live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WFP. We're going to get to that in a minute. We are streaming live and booming across the cold and rainy cornfields of the Midwest, reaching out to over 1.4 million listeners residing here in the Tri-County area. Being brought to you this morning by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and Barter's Financial Planning Services, along with a host of other very fine local businesses. With us this morning, my personality advisor, Elmo Schneider, joins us here in the Enchanted Kingdom this morning. Elmo.
AM 1050 WYIP is your...
Oops. Good morning.
I didn't even see his lips move.
I find that amusing. I should do that more often.
Well, when you said to me this morning, Wacky Wayne, you know, what are you going to do? And I said, well, we'll let, you know, open the door and let
make it up.
Yeah, make it up
as we go along.
Hey,
there you go.
But here's also with us my boyhood hero, our video coordinator, the former Love Doctor, Buddy Love, joins us here at Camp Happy Face.
Yeah, good morning, everybody.
Buddy Love. Your wife, explain to your wife that you now go by Buddy Love.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
How's she taking it?
Yeah, she likes it. Yeah. Hey, buddy.
She likes the name. It's you she can't stand.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Of course.
She always called me Buddy for some reason. For some reason. She
called
likes
us Buddy
word.
1,
yeah,
2.
She likes that name.
Yeah. So,
when you live together?
Yeah, yeah. You're in trouble now?
You know, we saw my good friend, former Alderman Bob issue. Johnson was in the production meeting last night, and he's with this really good-looking gal, and I said, who's that, your wife? He goes, no, it's my friend's wife.
Who's that?
And I goes, that's a novel approach. Have these married guys bring their wives down and, you know, entertain us a little bit. And, of course, engineering and board operating the Kenosha Today trolley ride this morning. Wacky Wayne is here with all my children.
Wayne. Couldn't stay away.
Ever get the feeling you're kind of like a hall monitor in grade school?
Very much so. Almost always.
This week, the Kenosha Today Secret Word Challenge is sponsored by Barter's Financial Planning Services, and the Kenosha Today Brain Trust has pre-selected this morning's secret word.
Spelled correctly?
Well, we got two versions.
That's what I figured.
It is spelled correctly.
Then there's the Webster Dictionary deal, and it's worth $20 if you happen to say the secret word. If you happen to spell the original spelling, we'll bump it up $5.
Sure.
We got a caller here, huh?
It's true.
Good morning, you're on Kenosha Today.
Well, that was nice.
That was not exactly a way to start out of the blocks.
No.
I know. I got to take that out.
Yeah.
Time to grab the sheet.
Yeah. we're not even a... You know, we haven't had that happen in a long time.
Yeah, that's a matter of opinion, yeah.
3 minutes in.
Is that the same person?
Yes.
Don't take it.
No. Definitely not doing that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no.
Anyway.
Okay. We've been there once, not going back to that well.
Nope.
How much paper you got there this morning? Of course, coming up after the 10:30 weather break, Kenosha's fastest growing game show sensation, the lightning round of City in Jeopardy, sponsored by the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. And then after the 11 o'clock break, what's so funny?
Just starting out like that. 3 minutes in and just...
Yep.
And then after the 11 o'clock break, this week's top 10 thought-provoking category, which is written on the deck at the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. At Amen Corner, where gray hairs matter, these are the top 10 reasons Kenosha should declare a state of emergency.
I thought we were in a constant state of emergency.
Confusion. And also during that half hour, we're going to play a little Stump the Chumps. Hey, Werner, Elmer, you're on a roll.
I'm going for the hat trick.
Yeah, the hat trick. 2 weeks in a row, nobody could stump you. Of course, my participation was I just let you handle all the publicity and get all the fame.
Let Elmo do all the heavy lifting, as it were.
Yeah, right.
Yep.
And if you're successful in stumping the chumps, we're going to let you join us for an upcoming show, and then you can just see for yourself what it's like to all the intricacies and the planning and the technology that goes into producing.
Yeah, you can feel like a hall monitor, too.
High-powered, high-energy, award-winning radio show like this. We even teach you how to... use the dump button log it in properly.
Yeah. We're leaders in artificial and stupidity.
Yeah. That's
okay. No, there's nothing artificial about this stupidity.
Well, like you say, you got to have goals.
Right.
We are leaders.
Set the bar low.
You know what? There's a thing here, if I can find it.
If you can find it.
No, there was a... here.
Ba-dum-bum.
Nominations are sought for Older American Award. And this is put in the news. In fact, it was in today's paper. Nominees must be Kenosha County residents aged 60 and over. That's me. Provided outstanding service to their community. That's me.
What service is
military service. That's me. Volunteerism. Commitment to family. That's me. Career achievements. And my dad always thought I was an underachiever with low self-esteem.
Right.
But I think this could pull me out of the...
pull you out of that gutter, so to speak.
Put me on the front page of the paper.
There you go.
You were there.
At least you'd be there for a positive reason.
Is that...
No.
No. Okay.
And, but thank you for asking.
And then, of course, there's even more, boys and girls, after the 11:30 break, our special weekly editorial segment as the...
Bong turns.
As the bong turns.
Oh, yes.
I think that has some... bong. I think that has some drug overtones.
Do you think so?
We're going to get into that because both our lovely governor... Our lovely governor.
You're lovely. I've got a lovely governor.
And the governor in Illinois, the guy in Illinois wants to, Pritzker, I think his name.
Yeah.
He wants to spend, Jimmy, $39 billion proposal includes more than $1 billion from legalizing recreational marijuana and sports betting.
Yeah.
Now, this is for Illinois. What could go wrong down there? And... it gets even better, folks, for those might have forgotten. Tomorrow at noon, each and every Sunday, you can relive all this magic here at AM 1050 and listen to the replay of this show. And tomorrow, there's just nothing on, right? There's no basketball games. There's no
football. Not during
games.
The day, yeah. Not
although the Brewers and the Cubs play by their first day a game today, and we're going to get into what the Cubs are going to try to do then.
Sure.
And then you can watch the replay of this finely tuned, professionally produced Excuse for Radio show on Spectrum's Channel 14, Tuesdays at 5, Wednesdays at 6 p.m., and then for you late night owls who might have a tendency to get overserved on Friday night, the ever-popular 2:30 a.m. Saturday replay is there for the viewing. I'd be interested to find out exactly if we have an attentive audience at 2:30.
Thousands.
Neither one of them?
Oh, here, hold on. We'll stop the show. No, neither one of these calls is available. So they will continue to blink at me.
Okay, I just was trying to
make sure I'm paying attention.
Off to a flying start today.
One blip and two non-takers.
A lot of non-takers. Nothing's come up available yet, so.
Of course, everybody can sign up with the thousands of our fans and listeners who have joined the Kenosha Today Nation. Like this on Facebook. And also on Fridays. Every afternoon, Friday afternoon, about 3 p.m., we get together at Amen Corner with our Boathouse production meeting, Getting Silly with Scotty. We had how many people? We had about 8 people there yesterday afternoon.
Yeah, Father Marcus was
Father
there
Marcus
for a while.
And Donut Dave, maybe.
Donut Dave, yeah.
Maybe we shouldn't be saying this on the radio because maybe Donut Dave wasn't there. You never know what.
Oh.
And, you know, like the married guys, they're like K-Dog, he's always out at Menards, standing in line for 3 hours.
He's mowing the lawn.
Yeah.
Morning, Shirley. How are you, dear?
Good morning, and I'm available.
That's right, you are.
Boy.
Well, we're going to have to fight off Gunga to make sure that availability stands.
Oh, yeah, my Gunga. Oh, I tell you, he is something
Shirley,
else.
Let me start with an incident that happened to me this week. I'm driving on the interstate, and I get pulled over by a Wisconsin state trooper, and apparently he claimed I was doing 100 miles an hour.
Wow.
So he says to me, "Well, I'm just about done with my shift," and he says, "If you can give me a very good reason why you were driving so fast, I'll let you off with just a warning." So I looked him right in the eye and I said, "Officer, here's the deal. Some years ago, my ex-wife ran off with a state trooper, and in all honesty, I thought it was you just bringing her back." So hard to believe he gave me a ticket anyway. So guy's got no sense of humor.
Oh, boy. That's funny.
Old joke.
Oh. Yeah. At any rate, you know, there's two big things here that could affect your little business. Wisconsin Governor Tony Evers is eyeing marijuana changes. He calls for decriminalizing possession of small amounts of marijuana for personal use and legalizing it for medical use. And of course,
I heard that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, the new governor in Illinois has got a $39 billion proposal. This is going to put you on the map in the pot making business.
No stems, no seeds that you don't need. Shirley's Garage has bad bleep weed.
I'm telling you, everywhere I go, people always say, "How's your pot doing in the garage?" Everywhere.
Well, you know, that's not a real... you're proud of that? I mean, right now...
Yeah, kind of.
So you go over to the church and you're little... you're trying to sell your booties over there. Or is that the senior citizen? You should take some little bags of, like almost says, stems and seeds and put them in the...
That's some harsh stuff, man.
Oh.
Yeah, right. That, my friends were telling me that is really a beautiful flower. It's a really pretty plant.
Your friends?
Yeah.
You have pot parties over at the church in the basement there, Dan?
They're knitting booties over there.
When I get in trouble, if I just grew one of those plants, you know, just for a plant in my house, would I get in trouble?
Not with us. Okay by you, Elmo? Yeah.
Well,
is it okay by you?
Yeah, you would right now.
Oh, okay. No, but it's okay by us, right?
I don't care what anybody
does. Buddy Love says it's okay.
Yeah, go
Wacky
for it,
Wayne
Shirley.
Says.
Yeah,
oh, Buddy Love, I love that name. Oh, how you doing, Buddy Love?
Yeah, but here's the deal. When the cops come and the FDA and they come with the SWAT team and they come to knock your door down, don't mention our names.
We can't be helped. I certainly will.
Well, thanks a lot. Hey, another traumatic thing, and this is a true story. This week was recycling Monday in front of Barter Manor. So I had a bunch of pizza boxes.
You got tagged.
And I put them in a blue bag.
Yep.
And I got yellow tagged.
They can't take pizza boxes.
Nothing with grease on it.
Because of the grease.
Well, I ate all the pizza.
Yeah, but I found that out too. They would wing it out of my lawn. You know, you take the boxes and just...
Well, here's a reputable guy like me. Gets yellow tag.
I'll put it in the regular trash.
I'm going to now. They think they're fooling around with me. You know, this crushed me. No garbage.
Two-time failed mayoral candidate.
Yeah, they put that on the bottom, too. Two-time failed mayoral candidate. And food contaminated boxes belong in garbage. Frozen food containers and pizza boxes. So I guess I wasn't aware of that. So, you know, I just thought cardboard was cardboard. But For you listeners out there, and the 1.4 million listeners that reside in the Kenosha Today,
the ones that recycle, this is for you.
Yeah, we do a public service.
That's right.
I should be for this Older American Award because there is a career achievements and substantial impact to the community. That's me. Look at this.
Substantial.
Right, you're doing a service to the community.
Oh, is he?
Way to service the community, Scott.
Moving out of state would be a service to the community.
No,
one constituent at a time.
You know, I wouldn't mind listing all the, you know, Elmo, when you fill up my resume, you list some of those names that I've serviced. Let's see how that works. Shirley, you got to go.
Okay, love your show.
Yeah.
And love all you guys. And Gunga, call.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, no, the phone's light up now.
Bye.
All right, bye.
Mm-hmm. Later.
Good morning, you're on Kenosha Today.
Yeah, so you all were just talking about legalizing marijuana.
Sure, okay.
Right.
You for
the
it?
The only reason people voted for Evers was because he's pro-marijuana.
Okay. Well, he got elected, so most people then must think he's that it's a good thing, right?
Absolutely.
Now, are you for just purely legalizing, or just you want to just keep it for medical use, or just might as well wide it open?
I mean, the founding fathers had already told us that we should grow hemp as far as the eye could see, but people couldn't distinguish between hemp and whatever. And then also hemp, although 4 acres of hemp replaces 1 acre of tree, and as far as paper mills and clut and everything else like that, it's just a better product. So why else was it legalized?
What is your first name?
I know who this is. You know
Kelly.
Her. Kelly.
Who?
Kelly.
Kelly.
No. Okay, Kelly, you know this, you know, seem to know a lot about this. Kelly.
Little bear-ish.
Now, we're not going to announce your phone number and full name until
after the
next hour. But how did you...
What? Wait, what?
We're not going to announce your full name and list your phone number to the next hour. So any police officers, they won't be knocking on your door wondering how you know so much about this marijuana stuff.
It's not even about marijuana. The hemp isn't... It doesn't get you high. You would have to smoke a telephone pole-sized joint to get high off of hemp. And hemp was made criminal for horrid reasons. Like, 4 acres of hemp replaces 1 acre tree. And how long does it take to grow trees compared to hemp? Like, 4 months for hemp, and it replaces an acre of trees? Like,
wow,
really?
Kelly, you know lots of stuff.
Actually, it was Randolph Hearst that led the... criminalization of hemp.
You know, I have
the newspaper.
But why did he make it criminalized?
I have no idea, but I know he was one of the leaders in doing it.
Why do you think then?
We don't do a lot of thinking. Hey, I got.
So why were our ancestors so ignorant to believe that movie called Reefer Madness?
I don't know, enlightenment.
What,
Kelly? Huh? Tell us. We don't know.
You know, the original name of Reefer Madness was like Protect Your Children or something like that. So, and they changed.
Okay, but why did our ancestors actually continue to stick with that? I mean, like, prohibition for alcohol did not last that long.
Nope.
Okay, 13 years, I think.
It just...
Seven?
But marijuana has lasted for how long?
Yeah. So I think you got a good... You got some good
some good points.
Suggestion. Mm-hmm. And I just have one question. You mentioned rolling a fat boy the size of a, what do you call it, telephone pole. How do you do that?
Basically, hemp cannot get you high. It doesn't have the THC in it. Also, if you don't heat up cannabis, you're not going to get high off of it either. So you could juice it and do everything else with and have the medicinal benefit without getting high off of it.
Plus, you can make rope out of it, which was the big thing. And it, you know, I think Hearst was in there because he was heavily invested in something that was a competitor to hemp, and he wanted to kill the market.
Oh, a competitor to hemp, which would have been what, cotton, paper industry?
Yeah, paper or something like that.
Well, so, Kelly, you're doing a
slavery and everything else. I mean, God, please, Kelly, keep going. Kelly. Or let's just go against minorities.
No, we don't want to go there. But, Kelly, you're bringing out a valuable service to the community, and I think...
I voted for Evers because Evers was pro-pot.
Okay, well, now I can list your phone number.
There you go.
555...
5555.
5555. Call Kelly.
Wait, what's the song? 847-309.
847-6309. I used to play that in a band.
There you go.
Okay, dear. Thank you for calling.
My lovely.
Bye-bye.
All right. 262-694-1050. Yeah, if you have a... what's he singing over there? If you have a comment on legalizing marijuana, give us a call. Yes? No. Hey, here's something I forgot to talk about last week. They are sponsored by the Kenosha American Legion Post. The Chili Cook-Off starts, it's today, between 12 and 4. Kenosha American Legion Post 21. And Pleasant Prairie VFW Post 7308. It's at the American Legion, which is, right under, above 58 below, right? What's that address?
Yep, I was below the American Legion last night.
Okay, so.
Along with Jumbo Jim.
JumboJimTron.com.
Yep.
Couple things other than if you think it'd be a good thing to legalize marijuana, 262-694-1050. And a couple other things in the paper, we can talk about that. I guess a couple of the gals over at Trumper, our old alma mater, got a little bit of a bind because they had their cheerleading banquet and were the subject of wide press all over and all over the country. And
kind of sounded to me like the Miss Kenosha Today pageant.
They gave the big booby award and they gave the big booty award. And, geez, I suppose maybe that's not the proper place, you know, having kids. But
not with all the parents there.
Yeah. I mean, it's okay to have it without the parents, right?
Sure.
I mean, that's what we're supposed to do,
Elmo. Just a bit of camaraderie, you know.
Yeah.
Just to, you know, you razz all your friends about that, and it's all good-natured fun.
Yeah, besides, you know, when they give them awards, like Wacky Wayne says, you got to have goals.
Right.
And so, you know, if we ever have our Kenosha, our Miss Kenosha Today contest, Elmo, we're going to have to give out, and forget this Miss Congeniality and that nonsense. That's too...
No.
We're going to have the big booty and the...
Shake that
string.
Shake that roll.
Big booty awards, I mean...
Okay, that's our second bleep for today. Yeah.
And, of course, our good friend, Patriots owner, Robert Kraft. You know, his team, the Patriots, have won 7 Super Bowls.
Six Super Bowls.
Well, the guy's 77 years old, and so he's not married. His wife passed away. He's got a young gal, but he's down vacationing in Palm Beach, Florida. And so he goes into a massage parlor, so to speak, and he got caught in this for soliciting a prostitute.
No, it's a massage therapy business.
Yes. Oldest.
Massage parlor is something else. Okay.
Yeah. Oldest occupation in the world, on the planet.
Right.
And so... Apparently, he was twice videotaped in an act, and I don't know if I was 77 years old if I'd want to be videotaped doing the deed there. But anyway,
I don't know that it was on purpose. Like he said, "Hey, why don't we tape this? I want to watch it later."
Well, maybe that comes with the package.
No, I don't think so.
Well, you know what? Now, hypothetically, just hypothetically.
Are you speaking from personal experience?
No, yeah, yeah. Hypothetical. Right. This was
sure.
If a guy...
Once upon a time,
he takes his ARP card. Now you get the discount.
Sure.
And it's a 10% or 15% discount on all the oils and
on the services,
and the
yes.
services and sure. the oils. And if you want to have yourself videotaped, that's a little extra. Hypothetically speaking.
In theory. I don't know
hypothetically.
Sure,
right.
Hypothetically. So anyway, 262-694-1050. So if you want to talk about that, if you think the Trumper coach, whatever you think about
cheerleading
that.
Cheerleading coach. Yep.
Cheerleading coach. And then Kenosha apparently, is not apparently, but they're going to buy a couple more buildings in the downtown, according to the Downtown Vision Development Project, and spent $1.6 million to purchase 3 downtown properties. And I guess the question is, should we be spending that kind of money on purchasing buildings, and yeah, I know they're going to put in a new city hall, versus spending $1.6 million and fix the roads.
Yeah.
I mean, our roads look like downtown Baghdad right now, and after this rain gets down in some of those.
And it's going to be 5 degrees tomorrow night. The roads are just going to bust apart.
They're going to buckle apart. And, you know, some of those potholes, I've said this before, they're so big.
Like a broken egg yolk.
Yeah, there's gift shops in the bottom of some of them.
Oh, yeah.
And so one... Pottle I
massage,
saw.
The massage, yeah. Massage parlor in the bottom of the pile.
Hypothetically.
In theory.
In theory.
With plenty of video cameras. It's a fantastic time.
Plus they have the, you know, the exit and the entrance ramp.
Right.
And they have the drive-through for people that can't wait.
Right.
A drive-through massage parlor in the bottom of one of our potholes. I think that's brilliant.
It's amazing.
This is why I should be up for this award. Is
that we'll work on the business plan.
Yeah, work on the business plan. Good morning, you're on Kenosha Today. Hello?
Goodbye.
No, hello? Hello?
Maybe.
You got to say something.
Gunga's going through a tunnel.
Gunga, is that him?
It would have been.
Gunga, call me back. I have questions
for
you.
Why don't we do this break thing we got to do?
Yep. All right, we'll do this. And then
kind of the weather
all right, thing? There he is right now.
You want to do it again? All right.
Yeah. Good morning, you're on Kenosha Today.
This is Gunga from Libertyville.
Gunga, my man. I got questions for you. You know this,
and I've got answers for you.
Oh, good.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy.
Our friend, the owner of the Patriots, I don't know if you heard this, he got caught in a, he got busted for soliciting a prostitute in Florida. Now,
correct.
The news that wasn't on all the wire services was there was another guy that was got pinched, and you can confirm or deny this. Apparently, this guy...
That might have been me, because I often frequent that place in Jupiter.
Well, see, this picture, it wasn't real clear, but this guy had a turban on, and his camel was out in the parking lot making a mess. So you want to confirm or deny that was you?
Was he giving or receiving services?
Yes.
Yes. All of the above?
Yes.
So how are you going to plead guilty with this?
I could go that way.
I've heard you've gone a lot of ways.
Yes. And I will not use the unicorn fragrance for reference.
So, very good.
When they arrested you, did they take Clyde too and put the cuffs around the humpers there?
I don't know how they do it. I think they put a ball and chain on their hump. Yes, possibly.
What if all your 9 ex-wives?
Kind of like a marriage.
Yeah. What's all your 9 ex-wives going to think about you getting arrested for soliciting in a massage parlor?
They really give no really any indication that they really care.
Well, I think it's just, it looks
like
bad
for them. But, gentlemen, I was sitting here rolling a fatty, and you were talking about the cannabis situation.
Sure.
How do you plead?
Hi.
I plead insanity.
Yeah. I think, if you're asking me why not? You know what? When they go back to Prohibition, who made all the money? Al Capone and Bugsy, those guys. And at least...
Yes, now Shirley will make a ton of dough.
And let her pay taxes on it, too.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. I think she's rich enough, however.
Well, she's rich in her
independently wealthy.
She considers you a friend.
Yes, I consider her. I nominated her yesterday on the radio to give her the Kenosha Booty Award.
How's that working out?
I don't know. Did she win?
Well,
are you having a contest?
Well,
she has the best booties in town.
Yeah, she makes the best booty in town. Well, we don't get involved, and we don't stoop ourselves to that kind of a level where we have to have trick contests to get people calling in.
No.
Yes, otherwise you'd have another Kenosha massage parlor you'd have to deal with.
You know, as long as you bring it up, why not legalize massage parlors? You know, this is the oldest profession in ever. You know, this goes back to Adam and Eve. You know, she was on
Happy
the
Happy endings?
Eve was, Eve was, she was the first prostitute on the planet. You know, they had that snake and that serpent thing all going for her.
You certainly are a wealth of knowledge.
Well, yes,
I would have never realized.
You know, they used to have them for women back around the turn of the 20th century.
Yeah.
They would have to go to the doctor to get treated for hysteria. I mean, they would just...
You know, that's what we could do, Elmo and Gunga. We could open up our own male massage parlor, and Father Marcus can bring us some of that fancy Kentucky jelly up. And we'll offer 10% discounts with
He's
your
He's got
ARP
the
card.
White panel truck. We can just...
Yeah.
What are you
right
offering to do? Massage me?
No, we have... Not you.
No.
Women.
Maybe Clyde.
Oh. Yeah, maybe Clyde. Bring him up and we'll give him the...
we'll give Clyde a massage. Is his hair growing back yet after you shaved it all off to make that house coat for Shirley for Valentine's Day?
It's growing back quite well, especially around the rump.
Oh, that's good to know. Gunga... Well, if you need a lawyer to represent you, we have the Kenosha Today lawyer who is from the firm of Dewey Cheatham and Howe. So we'll represent you. Well,
I have my own personal lawyer, Numbnuts Patel, probably the greatest lawyer in all of North America.
Yeah, but see, under Dewey Cheatham and Howe from the Kenosha Today law firm, we will provide conjugal visits. You there, Gunga?
Something to look forward to.
I don't know how to react to that one. Is that with you?
Yes, yeah, Scott.
With him?
Scott's going to wear
hypothetically.
A dress. Clyde.
Oh, thank you.
All right, we got to go to a break.
We got to go.
Thanks for calling, Gunga.
Thank you.
All right, now we've been.
Ooh, yeah.
Wow. Once again, a very good morning to everybody. This is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the February 23rd edition of the award-winning Kenosha Today Weekly Report, coming to you live from Studio A here at Pothole Central, spreading the love on the red-hot airways of WLIP to over 1.4 million people residing in the Kenosha Today Nation.
Kenosha land.
Kenosha land. And again, we invite you to join the thousands of our fans who have already signed up and liked us on Facebook. And we are brought to you this morning by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and Barter's Financial Planning Services, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. In the House of Potholes this morning, Mr. Elmo Schneider joins Aaron Carter.
Far out, man.
Wow. And then also the Kenosha Today Love Doctor. Buddy Love, the camera dude.
Yeah.
Well, we got some calls already. We better get into this wacky wing.
Yeah.
Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Hey, good morning, guys. Jeff from Kenosha with a double PSA.
Okay. Go ahead.
First off, if you're, any of our listeners are heading south from Milwaukee, plan a stop-and-go situation just south of Highway 11. I don't know how far south it goes because of the barriers that you can't see over.
Okay.
And just getting off at 7 Ryan Road because going into Milwaukee is all backed up. Nobody's being allowed on going north. And as far as north as I can see going over the bridge, it is nothing but brake lights.
Jeff, one quick question, then I got my phones are all lit up here. What is there lines at the adult bookstore?
You know what? I don't know which one, but...
What?
On the border seems busy.
All right. Okay. I don't think they're even open yet.
Okay, Jeff, thanks. Thanks for the information.
Yeah, it's important to know if you're going into Milwaukee for anything. So.
Great. Okay. Thanks. All right.
Very good.
Got another one? Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Well, let's see here.
Bubba.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How you doing, Bubba?
I want to talk to the two Kenosha personalities that are on this radio station that keep bashing the fine city of Kenosha, see? Now, we've got potholes, so does every city, and they don't have streetcar lines like we do, see?
Yeah.
Every town has potholes, but our city is concentrating on focusing on the downtown revitalization project, see?
Hey, Bubba, there was a picture in the paper today that online survey seeks opinions of on the uptown streetscape. Now, here's this picture they put in today. In this photo from 2016, a man walks in the uptown. They actually, this is a picture of the downtown. So I think the...
What's so funny?
Well, the Kenosha News tried to pull one over on Uncle Scotty, and that, they can't do that.
Kenosha News just ran a fine article about the Stella, see?
Yeah, I saw that. Hey, you're a man of Kenosha. Now, they're looking for an opinion for the uptown. Now, would you be for putting kiosks on every corner with bulletproof vests in the uptown area?
I was all in favor of expanding the streetcar line up to the uptown.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
If the streetcar line would go up there, everything would be perfect, see?
Okay.
Perfect.
This weather we have today reminds me of similar weather that we had back in 1976. We had an ice storm in 1976, I remember, see?
I think that...
It was a devastating ice storm. It snapped hundreds of utility poles and left over 600,000 residents in the southeastern quadrant of our state without power for up to 10 days.
Wow.
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 And we should care about this. Why?
Because we learn from the past, see?
I see. Well, maybe you should have a radio show dealing with stuff like that. You seem to know a lot
about...
Can't
wait for the Expo.
The Kenosha Today, the Kenosha No Show? Are you there?
Yeah, they're gonna have a booth there set up. I'll be there for 2 days, see.
Oh, wow. Signing autographs?
I've got this murder mystery. Maybe you can help me. And your listeners out there can help me try to find the two perpetrators that there was a double murder back in 1930... out on the roadhouse by Highway 50 and, let's see here, about 104th Avenue.
Ah.
Yeah. There was a double murder in Trevor.
They have never been brought to justice?
There were two perpetrators that were never caught, see?
That's what I said.
And let's see here. Let's look at the microfilm. Now, remember, there was a $500 reward at the time in 1930. That was a lot of money, see?
It's a lot of piaskers.
Yeah.
Hey, Bubba.
And we're trying to hunt down who who murdered the two innocent people in this saloon. It was a roadhouse, see? You know what that means. Probably, yep. Yeah, probably waiting for American Motors to come back like the rest of the people that sit in the saloons in Kenosha now.
Okay. Houses of sin.
Say, Bubba.
I remember, yeah.
Bubba, my lines are lit up, and we'll have to put this off for another time, but I appreciate your input, and I hope they
I'll
find
keep
those.
Working on this.
Yeah, and call us two jackasses anytime.
I got a wheelbarrow for the salad bar.
Okay, all right. I got to go, Bubba. I just got to go. All right. Good morning. You're on Kenosha today.
Nope. Good morning. How are you on this lovely weather?
Oh, very
spectacular.
Who's this?
This is Carol. Or should I not give my name as the previous caller? That sounds like someone that maybe, let's see, knows a lot about the past and history. Bubba?
Bubba.
Yeah. Bubba.
Bubba. Bouncing Bubba.
Whoever you are, Bubba, I think that you should come forward and give your real name because we'd like to know more about history. I love history. Do you guys like history?
I love history.
Carol, we don't want to throw more gas on this fire than already.
No, I do love history. And about you were talking about the marijuana, right?
Yeah, go ahead.
Correct.
Yeah, well, there's pros and cons. I don't know a lot about it, but I guess the hemp would be equivalent maybe to giving your cat catnip. I give my cat catnip.
No, not really. So hemp is actually legal
it
to grow.
Be?
Hemp
no.
is legal to grow in Wisconsin. They legalized hemp because it's. Yeah. They make rope and use it for other industrial purposes, and it does not get you high.
Having a dopey cat.
Yeah, but I think it's good for medical use. The not the hemp, but the marijuana.
Okay.
I personally do, but I don't know. I don't think they should. I don't know. It's kind of iffy. I don't know if they should legalize it because, of course, they're going to do it anyway, aren't they?
Yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So yeah. You might as well, you know, if they legalized it, and if they don't do that, they might as well legalize prostitution too, don't you think, Carol?
I really think so. As you said prior, that went way, way back, prostitution, you mm-hmm. know? So and what's the difference? It's between two consenting adults,
It's a business transaction.
The only time it's that it's not between two consenting adults, and then I got to go. It's when they're married.
Yep. you're right. Yeah.
I got to go, Carol.
Whatever.
Thank you, dear. Oh, I hear that. Whatever. That's a woman with an attitude, right? Good morning. You're on Kenosha today.
Good morning, man.
Who's this?
Bruce.
Bruce. Okay, Bruce. What's on your mind?
You got to give Bubba credit. That's one of the best stand-up or sit-down comedic things I've ever heard on the radio show. And I've got Bubba figured out because I listen to everybody but who Bubba's impersonating. And, man, that's some great shit.
It really is. And, actually, we've only met him the one time.
Yep.
He came into a production meeting and... introduced himself. I mean, I didn't know who this guy was. He was wearing a bear hat and a bear jersey. And I said, do I know you? And then he goes off into this thing for 10 minutes. And I goes, man, you got to call me more often because that is funny stuff. You're right.
Yeah. And just so Shirley knows, because obviously she thinks the station revolves around herself.
Yes.
She's got to have a tax deal for her pot in the garage.
Yeah,
I think each plant has to be registered and have to pay taxes on it.
Exactly. I'm all for that. All right, Bruce.
But yeah, you got to give Bubba his due. That's good stuff right there, man. Good morning.
All right, Bruce, thanks.
You bet.
All right, bye. Oh, look at the phones. Good morning. You're on Kenosha today.
Good morning. This is Irish Youth, a.k.a. English Ruth. And is this the city of the hottest mom?
The hottest mom? Yeah.
Yep, that was on the national news. But one good way to cut yourself off of your blessings. Also,
you're
going to
cut
like
off
to
my blessing?
Not you personally. You didn't have any blessings to begin with. Am I correct?
Yeah, hey, before you go any further, I'm running way behind. I've got to get in city in jeopardy.
So anyway, I'm going to address Bubba, the improper imposter. Bubba, did you know that the guy you're improperly impostering has the most knockout good-looking lady of all of the WLIP male radio personalities. She looks like Marilyn Monroe. And when we were at a WLIP event, a lady from Wadsworth said, "You mean she's the same age as we are?" And I said, "Yep, she's in her 60s."
All right, well, that's thanks for enlightening us. Hey, I was looking in my mailbox today, and I find this card.
Finally got the Christmas card.
I don't know. I just noticed it today. It was, I don't know, I can't read the postmark. But in it, there's this picture of a wedding. Whose wedding is this on a card?
That was my wedding.
Which one are you? Were you wearing
a
white?
A United States Marine, 2 years in Vietnam.
Okay, but were you the gal wearing white?
Of course, I'm the bride.
Well, who puts their wedding picture on the back of a postcard? And my next question is, there's a picture of a, that's about a 4x6 glossy. Is that you?
Yes, it is. Yep. And I would be embarrassed to be, and I looked like that in my 40s and 50s, and I would be embarrassed if anybody had said my mom was the hottest mom, or I had the booties or the boobs or whatever while I was in high school. Or in my 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, or 60s.
I hope your back doesn't get all bruised from patting yourself on the back, but you don't mind if we post this on our website then, huh?
Why?
It's a good question. Why? Well,
that's a great idea.
Well, we're going to doctor it up with a mustache.
The reason why I said it is because you were doing something regarding weddings and brides weeks and weeks and months ago.
Yeah.
So obviously, you know, snail mail, why ever it came there that late.
Well, it came postage due. Yeah. You owe me 50 cents.
Really? No kidding. Thank you, post office.
All right, I got to go. Thanks, Irish.
Bye.
Let's play the game.
Yeah, we got to play the game. But first of all, no one in the first half has won this secret word challenge. So if you're up to getting $20, you want to call us 262-694-1050. All right, we got to get to our game here, boys and girls. It's time to play Kenosha's fastest-growing game show sensation, the lightning round of City and Jeopardy, sponsored by the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. And to be eligible, no one from your household could have won any contest on WLP within the last 60 days. We'll now clear the phone lines, and I'm going to read the question, which is always a very sophisticated, intelligent, multiple-choice question. And you will then get three somewhat intellectual answers to choose from. And after that, you will hear the... And the first caller to correctly answer the question wins a Kenosha Today $25 gift certificate to the Boathouse Pub and Eatery, located at 4917 7th Avenue. Here in Kenosha, open Monday through Friday at 11 a.m., featuring weekly lunch and dinner specials, and to include reduced prices during the happy hours, Mondays and through Fridays from 3 to 6 p.m., and enjoy a beautiful waterfront view and stop in for their big Sunday brunch, serving from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. And if you're planning a party or banquet, call Joyce at 262-654-9922, or you can find them on the web at theboathousekenosha.com. Now, as everybody knows, 2nd District Alderman John Fox has resigned, and the City Council accepted his resignation last Thursday. Now, here comes the sophisticated question. What is the best way to fill a vacant city aldermanic seat? A, best 2 out of 3 cage match with City Council President Lil Anthony Kennedy. B, hold a special election, call it Votapalooza. Or C, just conceded to our Kenosha Today representative and flying high with Cy Costabile. First call, 262-694-1050. What is the best way to fill a vacant city aldermanic seat? Like it, Wayne.
No.
Oh. Okay.
Then I know you were commenting on Cy's window treatments yesterday. he needs to call our buddy Jeff, I think. So that's.
Do we have a caller there now?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Good morning. You're on Kenosha Today. Who's this?
This is Bernice.
Bernice. Okay, now hang on, Bernice. I'm going to build up the act here a little bit. You know, Bernice, that this is a very legitimate contest, right? And that today's very sophisticated question has been licked and sealed in an official Kenosha Today envelope and kept in a Long Island iced tea glass and Funkin' Wagnalls porch since last night's production meeting. And you, Bernice, with all your powers, being the all-omniscient, all-knowing, all-telling sage soothsayer and former Kenosha trolley driver, will ascertain the correct answer to this very sophisticated question. Right, Bernice?
Right.
Try to tape your enthusiasm, will you? All right. Did you want me to read the question?
It's A.
Pardon me?
A.
It's the first one.
What is the best way to fill a vacant city aldermanic seat? A, you say best 2 out of 3 cage match with City Council President Little Anthony Kennedy. Yes, that's a correct answer, Bernice.
Yes.
Boy, that I'd pay big money to see that, right?
Yeah.
You know, can you now? You got to visualize this. You know, we have to have this in the summertime, and we put this in. We'll get rid of the water in the city's ice skating rink, okay? And we put little Anthony Kennedy in there with some bright green stretch pants, and whoever the contestant is, they got to beat him 2 out of 3. And I'm gonna be there at the referee, and we'll sell tickets, and might have some. Concessions where we sell wine and or let people bring it in. What the heck?
Okay.
So, Bernice, do you listen to this dribble often? Meaning this show? Do you listen to this dribble, this show?
Oh, yes. Most of the time.
In the other part, you're in therapy?
What?
In the other time, you're in therapy?
I'm not in therapy.
Well, you said you listen to this show. There's one.
You should be in therapy if you listen to us.
Hold on, I better hurry up and make an appointment.
Yeah. Well, we got our Kenosha Today doctor, Dr. Bendover. He works out of a red panel truck in the Boathouse parking lot. So if you're a senior, you can use your ARP card and get a discount.
How did you pick up that name?
Dr. Bendover? He went to med school. That's what's on his
diploma. You were in med school together. We went to correspondence school together. That's
He's not exactly your conventional doctor. He's not really a ears, eyes, and throat. He's more of a kind of grab your ankles type of guy. So, all right, Bernice. Off the air here, Wacky Wayne's going to get your last name and address and phone number, and I'll mail this out on Monday to you.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Hey, we're a little behind here. Spider, try to stay awake for this. You're not at home sleeping with your wife.
He's not in the stool. He had to get himself a chair today. So it's
a recent job fair showed that jobs are plentiful in Kenosha County, and many of the employers are seeking to fill a bevy of openings. And what better way to seek qualified new hires than to take advantage of the very low Kenosha Today advertising rates and increase your ability to fill these positions? There are approximately 1.4 million people living in the WIP listening area, reaching as far south as North Chicago, west to Lake Geneva, and to the northern suburbs of Milwaukee. So if you're looking to fill any job, give me a call, 262-652-6767. We'll get you all squared away. And Elmo, once you announce the new promotion here. Oh, you lost your cord there. Elmo, we have this. Just so people know, we don't just... sit around and drink and BS at production meetings. We actually have a purpose. This came up out of...
Which promotion? I don't recall.
The naming rights of this
studio. Oh, yeah. If you want to get the naming rights to the studio, we just refer to it as Studio A here. So
we're going to... If you give us a call, 262... Actually, you're going to have to...
Yeah, you have a business or something? You want to go? We'll name the studio after you.
Yeah,
for a nominal fee, we will announce that.
And it'll be like hypothetically the Kenosha Today Shirley Studio. Of course, she should be known. Owns this anyway.
Shirley's Garage Studios.
Right. Yeah. No.
Yes.
No.
Okay. So anyway, 262-694-1050. When we get back from the break, we will have the top 10, and we'll play a little Stump the Chumps. And
we should do another commercial, though. So.
Why don't you do Pete's real quick here? Or, I mean, not Union Pete's. Park. Okay.
Union Park Tavern.
Blood between those two. And kneecap him in the alleyway. Mickey, you'll have to call us later and see how that works. Of course, we're talking today about legalizing marijuana. We can talk more about that when we get back. And the New England Patriots owner getting a little trouble there in a massage parlor in Palm Beach. And let's see, should the council be purchasing new buildings versus fixing the potholes? And if you have a comment on the banquet, the cheerleading banquet from Trumper, give us a call. And here was an article that was in actually today's paper. Here's the headline: Man Acting Crazy Arrested Outside Tavern. Who saw that coming?
4917 7th Avenue in.
They had this Dr. Seuss reading, you know, that there was a picture in the paper of these people reading these Dr. Seuss had. Well, this had to be about 10 years ago.
Okay.
Get this. They asked me to read to kids at Lincoln Elementary School.
I do not like green eggs and ham.
Really? They so, asked you to read to kids. You can barely read what you've got in front of you. And they're going to have you read
spell
to
either.
Kids. Right. And they're going to have you read to kids.
Well, here's...
That explains a lot.
Well, you think that's funny. Here's what happened. They gave me a thing. It was half in Spanish. Oh, and, you know, all these little kids just giggling and chuckling. And, you know, I could barely get through the English part. As
right.
You, thank you, pointed
yeah,
out there.
Yeah, no problem.
And one last question here. There was a hoax 9/11 call causes lockdowns in Pleasant Prairie last week.
And President's Day, yeah.
Well, what would happen if this studio gets this? Because this studio was locked down.
Yeah.
And so does that mean we just stay on the air for another couple hours?
No, we just sit here in the dark and don't answer the door for anybody.
That's right.
Or we send you out there as our emissary to make sure that there's nothing bad going on.
Kind of like Dog Day Afternoon or something
yeah.
like that.
Okay. Well, Scott, go handle the situation. We'll see you later, yeah. buddy.
Well,
I always want to talk to a guy.
Hey, I'll take a bullet from my friends.
Sure.
I mean,
your bullet?
Yeah, if you want me to, I'd throw my body on somebody as long as she was halfway decent.
Right. Even if she wasn't halfway decent. Beggars can't be choosers,
that's
Scott.
That's the kind of guy I yeah, am. I just keep giving and giving and giving.
Right, they keep taking and taking and taking. Yes.
Well, it hasn't been nobody's been taken.
No.
I'm in,
with all the hate texts, you'd think you'd have a little something on the back
yeah,
end.
Yeah, I'm in a, what do they call this? A horrific slump.
A horrific slump. A downturn. A drought.
That's to say it mildly.
Right.
It's 11.
Yeah. Good morning, everybody. Wow, man. You just joined us. This is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the February 23rd Pick-to-Click edition of the Kenosha Today Weekly Report. We are live and local here at Pothole Central. And if you just joined us in the Kenosha Today Encounter Group, we are broadcasting live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WIP on your radio dial, 262-694-1050. And as I mentioned right before the break, if somebody calls in a hoax and we are locked down, I guess the real bad news is we just keep on broadcasting.
No.
This whole show is a hoax, isn't it?
Well,
I've been a hostage here every Saturday for the last 2 years.
Yeah, but you're going to good news. Elmo just announced that what's March 16th?
Yep.
The gals are coming back.
I've been told.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make sure I'm here.
Yeah.
Just clear my schedule.
Memories of being an intern.
I'll have to bring in my defibrillator for Scott.
Yeah.
For people who don't know, this is Jumbo Jim Tron's having his burlesque show.
Yes.
On is that the following week, I think, isn't it?
22nd.
22nd and 23rd. Actually, I have a table for 8 that we're going and be right up front. So,
well, good for you. That's way past my bedtime.
I was talking to K-Dog. You know, Captain's going to be back by that time, so I think they're going to go as a couple to the...
Kenosha campus couple. Oh, couple of what? Yeah, I hope Captain calls us, too, because I got some information for him. And, of course, as I think it was Jeff that called, and traffic on the interstate, as you get closer to Milwaukee, probably from KR all the way up to
Ryan. I think
Ryan
they got
Road.
Some ice problems up there. That's what I'm guessing.
So we are a public service, see? And we got callers, and, of course, according to Jeff, the line at the adult bookstore seems to be
just fine.
Just
yeah,
fine.
And nothing to worry
border,
about
there. Yeah, plenty of free parking at
yes.
on the border. So, okay, we got to cover all the gamuts.
You know, all
I don't want to leave nobody out.
No.
We are being brought to you by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and Barter's Financial Planning Services, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. As you can tell, we are taking serious journalism.
Very serious.
To an all-time high. We span the globe. Reporting on national, state stories, local issues. Basically, we're just here. We're your go-to guys for all the fake news stories that are being reported. And joining us here at Pothole Central, my personality advisor, Elmo Schneider, is here in the house.
Yes, I am.
Somebody asked me last week, if you're my personality advisor, you must not be doing your job very well.
When did I become personality advisor?
I don't know. Well,
a couple weeks ago.
Because you were my relationship advisor, and that didn't work out real well either. Also with us.
Kind of a drought. Huh?
Yeah, it's kind of a drought. I could be in Pakistan with Gunga.
Death Valley days, right ahead again.
Also with us, every young snot-nosed little kid's role model, our video coordinator, Buddy Love, is here.
Look, turkey permits are up 750.
Yeah, that's good.
Yep.
The what?
Turkey permits.
Turkey shooting.
Yep.
I guess we had to bring that.
He's staying informed.
Yeah. He pulls a newspaper out of the trash here. Yeah.
What's the date on that?
1987.
Performing as both our engineer and board operator, a role model in his own right, Wacky Wayne just embraces us with his presence this morning.
Oh, yes.
January 11th.
Very well embraced.
As always, my question to you every Saturday, this is the big question. Any reason that the Lord should be weeping?
I don't know. He pretty much is.
Oh, we're on the air.
Yeah, we are on the air. And do you ever get questions or during the week and say,
no, nobody
what's it really
asks
like
me.
Sitting
no.
across from these morons?
No, not at all.
That's good for you then.
Yeah, I'm dodging bullets. Nobody wants to talk to me about it. They're like, nah, that guy suffered enough.
Nobody's offered you a bribe to hit the right button? Because you're the only guy that got the power
right.
to wipe, take us right out of here.
Right, right out of there. Yeah, and nobody's asked about that. I wonder why nobody can hear Scott. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, we'll turn his mic back on. Oh, yeah, you're back.
Okay,
all right.
You're back. Hey,
right.
You know what? Speaking of fundraising, don't put him back. We have this fundraising for our guy that we're running for alderman in the 2nd District, Cy Costabile.
Yes.
We're up to $2 and about 31 cents.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Okay.
We're getting there.
No, we're getting there.
Doing some serious fundraising.
Oh.
Now you got to do is get some people on the streets to get that petition signed.
The money is being held securely in a styrofoam go box from the boathouse.
In the back seat of my car that's clearly marked scum on it. So, what could go wrong there?
Nobody's going to break into a car that's already labeled scum.
I was going to, in fact, a week ago, I sent the renewal for my plates. Now,
sure.
I got the vanity plates and says K-E-N.
Says scum.
T-D-Y.
Yeah. Right.
So those are $90. So I put them a note. I said, just forget the vanity plate. Here's my $75. They sent me a notice that I'm $15 short. And in order this to renew by this next week, I had to send them another check. So I don't know what's going on here.
Government in action.
And plus, you know, between that and I was traumatized when I got this yellow tag.
The yellow tag.
For my garbage.
Because it wasn't on your toe.
You know,
that's true.
Like I said, it could have been.
All greasy.
I've been, if I was going to put my, because I've been kicked to the curb so many times, if I put this on my toe and put myself in a parkway.
When we stick your carcass in a cardboard coffin and put you out on the curb, okay, you're going to get one of those.
Get one of these. You must recycle this guy. Anyway, what are we at? Oh, status of this morning's Secret Word Challenge, sponsored by Barter's Financial Planning Services. And if you get the word, you get your $20, and if you happen to spell it the way I originally spell it, you get another $5.
Look at us.
Who can be just giving away? Just
look at
giving,
you being
giving,
all
giving.
Giving and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. And then we'll see if Captain Mike calls because I got an update on his house on the fire over there. Okay, this is, you ready?
As ready as I'm going to be.
Okay. Uh-oh. Written in our home office at Amen Corner.
There's 10 of them, right? You haven't had that problem in a while. I'm just making sure.
I'm an accountant. I'm pretty good at this.
You can count.
Counting
the time.
Backwards.
Yeah, right. Not adding up, but subtracting. Yeah. Gotcha.
Written in our home office at Amen Corner on the deck of the Boathouse Pub and E, where gray hairs matter. This week's top 10 thought-provoking category: the top 10 reasons Kenosha should declare a state of emergency. Number 10: more than two people were seen riding on the trolley. Number 9: the rocket car washes and all our potholes are kaputsky. Number 8. We have finally removed the last of the duct tape from the WIP studios. Number 7, Nancy Pelosi and Chuckie Schumer are now working for Foxconn. Number 6, we have completely run out of Kentucky jelly. Now that's
an emergency.
State emergency.
Call Father Marcus.
Number 5, former aldermen are joining a cult to be community watchdogs. Number 4, 1 in every 10 Kenosha Today listeners are seeing a therapist. Number 3, liberal ordinance that allowed Jimmy Hoffa to build a house here without having a permit. Number 2, where else can you be ad hoc and still be on a school board? And the number one reason Kenosha should declare a state of emergency, the wall around the Lincoln Park Lagoon is crumbling. I still
yeah.
I rush it a little bit.
A little bit.
You know, I get the old adrenalines.
You don't even drink coffee here, so that's.
Yeah, I don't. I never drink coffee.
No?
I've never had acquired a taste. It
interferes with the booze.
Yeah.
I see the problem.
Hey, on this day in history, 1907, President Theodore Roosevelt signed an Immigration Act which excluded idiots, imbeciles, free as blinded persons, epileptics, and sane persons from being admitted to the United States. Well, that's all of Congress right there. I mean, how can, in 1907.
Just making sure I got an idea.
Know, actually,
that.
Nobody would
How'd
have
you
ever
get your green card. You know, right?
Nobody ever would have noticed that little miss.
You've got me hanging on your every word week. That's what I'm supposed to do.
Hang on.
Yeah.
Another article in the paper today or this week: Wisconsin schools are behind in offering breakfast. In Wisconsin, low-income students' participation in school breakfast program fell by 400 students. Why are we giving kids free breakfast?
I don't know.
You know, I told you guys a couple weeks ago, there's, in my subdivision of 250 houses, they bus students to Summers Elementary.
Sure.
Well, there's a bus that comes through at 7.
Right.
Because they take, I can understand it, but they take them over to the school for free breakfast, and the school's basically providing a daycare.
A second meal.
And then after the school.
Communist indoctrination camps, we will feed you and raise you from cradle to grave. That's all it is.
Way to go,
that's
comrade.
What they want.
Way to go, Comrade Elmo. And then afterwards, I can see that they have a bus that takes them to a regular daycare, after school care. But
sure.
I don't know why we should be spending our tax dollars for breakfast. I mean, is there something that says, I know they probably did some million-dollar study that said kids learn better by having breakfast.
Breakfast, right.
We
feel that your parents are too incompetent to know how to give you breakfast, so we will do it for you.
I'm sure that's true in certain instances, but
yep,
I mean, really.
A couple of them, but they should be dealt with on an individual basis and not.
One of the big, I'll take this. I'm good. Good morning, you're on Kenosha today.
I heard Summers. Any updates on that double murder from 1930?
Way to go, Bubba. Thanks for calling me back. Yeah, actually, we were talking about, you probably know a lot about this, the last guy that got executed before they abolished it in 1858,
John McAfee. The day before Jumbo Jim's birthday, August 18th.
Tell the last name there. I want to look that up.
Yeah, and McAfee?
M-C-H-A-F-F-E-Y.
M-C. Okay. Computer's not working.
And you know what? They hung him.
They run a scan on my computer here.
They hung him in Library Park before about 3,000
people.
And you know what he got sentenced to the death penalty? He drowned his wife in the back alley in a cistern.
Oh, boy.
While his neighbors watched. She was nagging him so much he said, I don't care. So
there's a lesson to be learned there, Bubba.
Don't commit crimes around the childhood home of Orson Welles.
You know, that was a couple years ago when we celebrated the, remember that? The
100th anniversary?
Yeah, every day for the whole week. You know, Orson Welles spent like just a year here. But here we spent a whole week with big articles, and you were probably instigating that, why we celebrate Orson Welles. He never came back here. He's not even buried here, is he?
Nope.
He just was born around Library Park. So,
Buddy Love, you just did some painting over the house, didn't you? Yep.
Yeah, I want to talk about the trees that are over on 30th Avenue by the old Chrysler plant.
Okay, what about them?
Well, they were planted, and then some jackass decided to drive a car through after they were planted shortly thereafter. Only about half of them are still remaining, if you're interested.
Oh, we're hanging on here everywhere. So did the city replace them?
See.
No. But the trees are there. I believe they were planted right around 1987.
Uh-huh.
We are listening audience out there still interested. I'm looking for those two suspects in that Trevor double murder in 1930. Anybody out there listening that helped
you
me
out?
Got
a clue?
Maybe Bruce can help.
We had a caller.
Loving you.
Bruce said he thought you were the greatest thing on the radio.
Who?
A guy named Bruce. He's a big...
A guy named Bruce.
Bruce, yeah. See?
Let's see here.
He likes salad bars.
Yeah. You might have ran into him in a salad bar.
I like the grilled shrimp over rice along with the buttered corn. A 5-gallon bucket.
So what's the proper number of soups in a salad bar?
I thought we
should have at least two soups. and perhaps a spicy chili, and then also a lot. I like crackers. A trunk full of crackers.
See? Now the crackers are free, right?
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Hey, we were talking about
they
this.
They also have. They probably, if it's a real salad bar, they would have a free toaster that you could use. See, a toaster.
What's your feeling?
Right next to that trunk full of crackers that are free.
Hey, Bubba.
Do you have a free newspaper at the radio station?
Yeah. I got another question to ask you. Should we legalize, the state of Wisconsin legalize marijuana and prostitution?
No.
Why?
No, I'm all in favor of closing down these saloons that are still around the old American Motors.
Roadhouses.
The only people that sit in these saloons are still waiting for American Motors to come back. I already said that.
I thought they were. I thought they were making a comeback along with Studebaker.
They can't close them fast enough.
Okay. I got to take another call, Bubba. thanks for the wealth of information. But, hey, if we get to the bottom and we find those two perpetrators, we'll get you a call. Okay.
Oh.
Good morning. Good morning, on Kenosha today.
Should can you ask him about his book?
Who's this, Paul?
Paul from Racine. Yeah, I want to know about his book and when I can buy it and where he's going to be signing it.
He's probably going to be signing it at the Kenosha No Show or the Expo.
Well, the rumor I had heard was at the Stella, but three cars and salad bars. I cannot wait.
Hey, you don't know anything about this murder in 1930 with
out in Trevor,
because they haven't.
Was it Summers?
I thought you said Trevor, but they haven't found these two characters since 1930.
Well, I don't know anything, but I have full confidence that Bubba will get it figured out. I mean, he's relentless. You just hear it in his voice.
He's a bulldog.
He's
a bulldog, and he's got real command and real conviction. And I cannot wait to read the book.
He's got a real future.
You guys have a great day.
He's got okay, Paul. Okay. 2629.
It's time to play.
Time to play, boys and girls. Here at Studio A. By the way, we are still looking for somebody that wants to sponsor the naming rights for this studio instead of. You know, Studio A is so lackluster. You know, we want to put some emphasis in, and you'll be a sponsor and have the studio named after you.
Looks like it may be like Listerine mouthwash or something like that. Would be good.
Yeah, just like that. Have a little wiener mobile. Good morning, you're on Kenosha today.
This is Ganga from Libertyville. Oh. I would like to comment on your 1910. I remember it well. It was all the people that drank through 1910.
Okay.
It was a very good year. Is there no limit to your ignorance?
No,
pretty much.
Thank you. You answered the question of the day. Thank you. Okay. Have a wonderful one.
Thank you, Gunga.
I wouldn't put it like that. You know,
is there no limit?
No limit.
Speaking of ignorance,
what?
Play the game.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe. Unless we lose our place.
Where am I at here? Stump
Studio
the chumps.
A.
Stump the chumps.
Squirrel!
If you work successful in stumping the chumps, you will then have the privilege and high honor of joining us as a guest host here in an upcoming show. And it's a huge opportunity for our audience to bring something of intelligence, sophistication. I mean, I can't be the only one that's in Elmo. We can't be the only smart guys here.
No.
Going for the hat trick this week.
After the phone lines are clear, I guess we don't really have to clear the phone lines
good.
For this
deal. We're good.
We're going to take your trivia question or song title, and the first caller to successfully stump the Kenosha Day Chump Switch this morning is Mr. Elmo and Buddy Love, Wacky Wayne, and of course myself. And hit me with your best shot there. Now, that's not a question. Somebody called in one time after you played that.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, it's Pat Benatar.
Thank you very much. We know that.
So, 2-6 new if you want to play Stump the Chumps. Elmo's on a roll 2 weeks in a row. He's going for the hat trick. And while we're waiting for that, I better recognize KRS Painting Corporation.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Well, I'm not going to say
that. No, probably not a good idea. Yeah. Let's not.
We'll tell you at the break. So.
Oh. Okay. Well, Anyways, back to this chili cook-off, sponsored by Kenosha American Legion, Post 21, Pleasant Prairie, VFW Post 7308. And it's in American Legion Post 21, which is on 58th Street, right above
58
below. Yeah. That's where the incident took place last night.
You were with JumboJimtronMan.com, and he cut the cheese or something?
He kind of cleared out half of the bar.
Wow. Oh, boy. Lucky.
At least he admitted it. You know, he's not...
That was a good one.
Huh? That baby's got some hang time. Anyway, the big shoe mishap. Duke was playing, who were they playing, South Carolina? And this Duke's Zion Williamson, who's only a freshman, he's going to be probably the number one pick.
Pick, yep.
Just a couple seconds into this game, his Nike shoe fell apart.
His foot went right through the shoe.
And by the end of the day, Nike stock went down almost 2%, or 1%, 97 cents a share.
Chinese knockoff, maybe.
Yeah. And so now, if the question that maybe some of our sports enthusiasts can address, should this guy, now he's got a kind of a sprained knee, should he just bypass the rest of his college basketball and just keep himself for, the pros, which he's going to be a pro anyway. And if he gets hurt again, he could end up forfeiting into the billions, I think. And
lots of cash.
And if you're Nike, I don't think he's going to take an endorsement deal from them anytime real soon, you think? and Nike's still, they're looking into this, how this worked.
How the shoe just disintegrated?
Yep. Yeah. Well, no, the shoe just kind of
fell apart.
It's got something like a size 14, but the shoe just kind of course, the guy's 280 pounds.
You know, somebody might have sabotaged it.
Remember the Tanya Harding and Nancy Kerrigan back some years ago? Where, was it Gahooly or Wahooly? Beat her up and broke her kneecap.
Yeah.
So, and then Duke ended up, I think they were rated number one. They ended up losing that game. So, also in the sports column this week, the Cubs are thinking of launching their own sports network in 2020.
They already are. It's a done deal.
It is?
Not thinking. They're doing it.
I mean, so in other words, the Cubs forever, you could get them on Channel 9 with old Jack Brickhouse. Hey, and if Harry Carey, if you're up there in heaven, Harry, and you're listening, I'd like you to call me about this, get your input on this, because I think the Cubs are just, somebody else tried this out in the West Coast, and it was a disaster. Basically, it's pay-per-view. You can't get Cub games free anymore starting in next year.
Well, the White Sox did it some years ago.
And it was a disaster.
Sports Vision or something like that.
Yeah. If anybody wants to weigh in on that, because I think that's a disaster, because you take the Cubs, I mean, they were, they have a fan base.
Right.
And they got that way because, in my view, they offered
free TV. Well,
that's
when WGN was, they were national on cable. So
they're the
super station back then, and you could watch the Cubs anywhere in the country.
You know, and these guys, these athletes, as long as I'm on that, of course, the Padres, some ungodly to Manny Machado, $300 million for 10 years.
What?
And the
I get that for one night.
To stay home.
Well, if that's the case, Elmo, I'm going to be hanging with you a little more often. Just to pick up the crumbs.
Sure.
And the Brewers signed this Mike Moustakas.
Yep.
$10 million for 1 year, and the guy only hit .256.
What?
.256.
Yeah, but he's a great fielder, and he hits him out of the park. That's the,
Well, he had 8 homers. Of course, this is with the Brewers. I don't know what he had.
I think he was
28
with,
homers he had.
Yeah, he was with KC before.
Yeah. But $10 million. No wonder these prices are going astronomically. It used to be, I think, the family of four.
Whatever the market will bear.
Yeah. Well, the fans are stupid enough to go pay for this. $30 bucks for a hot dog, and that's just outrageous. And, as long as the people keep paying it, then these guys will keep making this ungodly sum of money. When I renegotiated our contract here, we're just a little bit under that. when I said, what do we have to get to keep us under the salary cap? And that's about what, the business.
Can I pay in Keystone Light?
Yeah.
I've got barter coin.
Barter coin, yeah. So anyway, if somebody thinks that Mr. What's-His-Name Duke's Zion Williamson should just bypass these last few games and just sign up for the pros. Because obviously he's not going to, after basketball season, he's not going to go back and get his, go to class. He's probably not going to class now. You know, he's got to.
You don't know for sure.
Nope.
Well, come on.
Let's, call me when you have class.
Call me when you got class. I got no class. But anyway, doesn't look like I have a lot of sports people. Look at, good morning, you're in Kenosha today.
Hi, it's Cindy. How are you doing?
Hey, Cindy. Hey. Happy birthday, belatedly. So.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Steve. I'm calling because you were talking about WGN, and I just discovered that this week that they're not on the Spectrum menu at all anymore.
They could not negotiate a contract.
And
I don't understand why. And they said they were owned by the same company as Channel 6.
Yeah, it could be.
Fox.
I never knew that.
Fox is WI. Isn't Fox Channel 6?
Well, they're an affiliate, but ownership is different.
Oh.
Well, now in order to watch the Cubs starting next year.
Yeah.
Well, we can get the Cubs if we go through. Ron, if you have those antennas like you got.
Over the air?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can get. All right.
Yeah, I can get WGN over.
But you won't be able to get this.
No.
So what do you think, Cindy? Is that a bad idea for the Cubs to go to this pay-per-view?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so.
Surely it'll go nuts.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's people there. I don't know. I've been there to see a game, and I don't understand how somebody would pay for a ticket and then go downstairs and sit in the saloon and watch it on the TV.
Yeah, those.
When you can do that at home.
Yeah, you know what? Bubba has a good point, say. We want to get rid of those saloons.
Cool.
We want to get rid of the saloons. But, Cindy, I got a question.
Sure.
You're out in Salem, right?
Well, yeah.
Kind of.
Salem, Antioch.
Well,
here's I have a Trevor phone number, and I live in Salem, but my mail comes from Bristol, and I have to vote in Salem.
Sounds like
Kenosha County.
Sounds like somebody's chasing you around the southeastern Wisconsin.
That's how it is out here.
But here's my question. Well, this is probably why it explains all this. Mm-hmm. Salem Lakes, that's out by you, right?
Yeah, I guess that's what they call it.
Have a committee that's charged with hatching a plan to regulate the keeping of chickens in residential areas.
A chicken committee.
Committee.
That's good, because honest to God, I live in a little subdivision, and we had a guy over here behind us. A couple years he had a chicken. I don't know what happened, but it used to crow every morning.
Probably on somebody's barbecue grill.
Something. Excuse me, I've got a really bad cold.
I got attacked by a pet chicken a couple of years ago. You don't remember that?
I was attacked by a goose when I was a kid.
But, you know, is this all they got to do out there in Salem is to form a committee?
They have committees for all kinds of stuff out here. It's just...
There's nothing else to do.
And nobody shows up. They have committee meetings and nobody shows up except the same five people. And they meet at the saloon over in Trevor.
That's a good idea.
That's a good place. And then, you know what... Now that you're not going to be able to watch Cub games anymore, you might as well get together at the saloon and figure out how you're going to keep residential areas with chickens. Right. It says the village, rather than voting to amend the village's chicken ordinance, the village board, I'm reading this, I'm not making this up. The village board voted unanimously.
They need a turkey ordinance is what they need.
That's what we need here.
That's what we need here, yeah.
Okay, 750 permits.
Voted unanimously to include residents on a committee to take a comprehensive look at the issue. And the vote comes following a public request last week to allow youth to keep up to two hens for county fair projects. And then requests by others for village to reconsider the ordinance. So right now you can't have a chicken in Salem.
I can't?
Well, I don't know. It doesn't sound like it.
No.
In the freezer.
I get them. I get mine at the store, and then I bake them.
Yeah. You know, Kenosha floated this idea, and in my subdivision, there are deed restrictions that strictly spells out you can't have chickens or the coop. You can have the grill if you want to end up putting in there, but people didn't realize that. Now, in some of the older neighborhoods that didn't have deed restrictions.
Yeah.
But anyway, that chicken plan...
my mother used to tell one about the guy that, I think she said it was a Scotsman, that was out in the chicken coop and thought he dropped his chewing gum and thought he picked it up several times.
Well, that's anyway. We get it, but anyway.
But yeah, that's what I think about their chicken ordinance. I really don't care.
All right.
Speaking of chicken, Union Park Tavern, 4528th Avenue, Kenosha has fantastic.
Put my chili in there.
Well, it's this afternoon.
It's
kind of too late to.
I had this last weekend because we had visitors in here last week and kind of got lost by the shuffle. But you can go over there and for $5.
Yeah, I'm pretty sick today. Yeah. But next time you're going to have that, let us know a couple weeks ahead so
next
we can get in on that.
Yeah, it's sponsored actually by the Kenosha American Legion Post 21.
Okay.
And Pleasant Prairie VFW Post 73.
Is anybody still over there?
Yeah,
the upstairs. Legion,
sure. Yeah, that's where the American Legion is.
Woody's there.
Yeah.
Woody, our man Woody.
Okay.
All right.
I haven't been up in there for years when somebody had a wedding years and years ago.
We try not to attend weddings, but gives us the
heebie-jeebies.
You don't want the bad luck to rub off.
Although Iris Ruth sent us her wedding picture, and believe this or not, she was the one wearing the white gown.
Really?
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, what's that? I got to go take a break.
Yep.
All right, thanks.
All right, bye.
Bye.
All right, we'll got to take the last break. Things. You got to love it, man. You got to love it. We are back and heading down the home stretch. On the Kenosha Today trolley ride this morning here at Pothole Central. If you just joined us, this is the February 23rd edition of the Kenosha Today Weekly Report. And the good news, we are still broadcasting live to over 1.4 million people residing here in the Kenosha Today Nation. And the bad news, I guess we're going to be here every Saturday for the rest of the year. We got some great shows coming up. A couple weeks, we're going to have the burlesque girls here.
Girls are going to be in, yep.
And
on the 16th.
Do we have to do anything special? I mean, do I have to wear, probably have to take a shower that morning, huh?
Be a good idea.
Okay. We'll have to be on our best behavior, Wacky Wayne.
I'll be fine. It's you I'm concerned with.
Yeah.
What?
You can't talk when they're here. You get all sweaty.
Well, if she wouldn't touch my shoulder.
Yeah, yeah.
If she even looks at you with the side eye, you're like,
Well, if they come in here so scantily dressed and, you know.
No.
I'm so impressionable.
They've got plenty of clothes on. You're just thinking of them scantily dressed, and that's
maybe
the
that's
problem.
The problem.
Yeah.
Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Hey, Scott. How's it going?
Dennis.
Hey, Dennis.
Hey, I don't know if you heard, we're looking for sponsors to get the naming rights of Studio A. So how does this sound? If you were a sponsor, it would be the Kenosha Today, Dennis and What's-Her-Name Studio.
That sounds great.
Oh,
that sounds absolutely wonderful.
Fantastic.
Okay, we'll sign you up and give you a bill. What's your take on this legalizing marijuana?
You served in law enforcement.
Served in law enforcement.
Well, you know, it's interesting because I was going for my master's degree at Governor State University, Illinois, back in 1990, and there were freshmen in the class all the way up to people that were in graduate status. And that was one of our topics in class back then, to whether they should legalize it. And the consensus back then was not to do it because everybody knows that people abuse substances, even ones that are legal, but you're just giving somebody another substance to abuse. And I think the main consideration here should be the medical costs that it's going to take to rehab more people that are going to get involved with it.
So, Dennis, you're saying, so let's say alcohol, there's alcohol abuse, and then if we allow drugs, there'll be drug abuse, and you're married, so what about marriage abuse?
Spousal abuse.
That's true.
Spousal abuse.
That's true, but that could be solved like the story of the cannibal and his son. Did you hear that one?
No.
Get the toilet ready there, Wayne.
Yeah. Hovering over the button now.
We've already had one. Don't do it to us again.
This cannibal and his son were very hungry, so they went to a path through the jungle where a lot of people passed through. So the first person passing through was a really large lady, and the son said to his dad, "Dad, how about her?" And the dad said, no, we'd get too much cholesterol if we ate her. We can't eat her." Next to an old man walked by, and there was not hardly any meat on his bones, and his son said, "How about him?" And his father said, "No, he wouldn't have any meat at all for us. We couldn't eat him." Next, a gorgeous woman walks by, and the son goes, "Dad, how about her?" And his father goes, "No, we can't eat her." So the son goes, "Dad, why not?" His father goes, "Because we're taking her home and we're going to eat her mom."
I stayed awake for that whole thing for that.
Yeah. It's too bad they couldn't find a good salad bar out there in the jungle.
So. Hey, I got to tell you.
You know, I'm going to help look for those two suspects, though, in that murder.
Yeah, they're still at large, 1930. And if you know of their whereabouts, you probably have to look it up on microfilm. And then the other thing is, Irish Ruth called today. And you're good friends with Mickey O'Shaughnessy, right?
Oh, very good, yes.
She sent us her wedding picture. I don't know what year this was, but get this. She actually wore white.
Well, you know, put it this way. Anybody can choose different color clothing, but I don't know if the white has any meaning in that case.
In a nutcase? You call her a nutcase?
That's but somebody else.
There was a kidney stone development.
Oh, yeah. How's that working out?
Well, it was holding out about as long as Bryce Harper and Manny Machado. But I can't hold out any longer. I had an attack on Thursday night, and I called the urologist, and he said, enough waiting since you had the attack, and it was very painful. He said they really got to go in and get it now, so. That's okay. What's going to happen.
Good luck.
Well, thanks for sharing your medical history with us. 1.4 million listeners are probably just hanging on your every word. On how are they going to... No, I guess we don't want to know how they're going to go get it.
Well, just a little tip for you youngsters out there. Don't try kidney stone removal yourself.
All right, Dennis. Well, I guess you're probably... getting ready for the shopping season and all the mall shopping season where your wife drags you to every shopping mall in the Midwest on the weekend. So,
I probably will. And, you know, I heard that you went to Trumper High School, right?
We both did.
They're mighty proud of us.
Yeah, I heard that when you were there, they had contests for the boys. There was voting for the boys, and I heard that you were voted in one of the categories.
Do I dare ask why? What category?
No, I'm not going to vote. You can surmise a guess.
Yeah, okay. All right. I got to go take another caller, Dennis. Say hi to the miss. Right, oh, by the way, I might be able to get out there Wednesday, tell her, and fool around with her, but I hope you got some new vodka and some chips for me.
Oh, come on. All right. Later.
It's bad enough I got to fool around with the guy's wife. Now, he doesn't want to even front me some chips.
Yeah. We need to give a clue for
give
the
a
word.
Clue for
so
the,
we're way past due.
Yeah, okay.
So today's clue is Mamma Mia.
262-694-1050. That's for the secret word. Hey, big thank you to the Boathouse Pub and Eatery, 4917 The Chumps. You can give us a call. We got a couple minutes left here. And let's see. We're probably... We forgot High Fives and Zingers and Doofuses, our special editorial.
Editorial. I can't say it. Don't
maybe
spell
I'll take
it.
A phone call, first of all.
Sure.
Good morning. You're in Kenosha today?
Hi, it's Cindy.
Yeah.
And I'm a guess that the secret word is meatball.
That's two words.
Incorrect.
Incorrect.
It's one word.
Meatball's it's one word.
Okay.
Okay, you still lose. Boys and girls, it's time for this week's special editorial. What?
That's two words.
Meatball.
Well, it can be two words or it can be one word.
So. It's hard to believe. I tried to tell my dad that I was a straight-A student, four-point student.
Yeah.
You heard how that went, didn't you?
It didn't go well, as I recall.
Well, he's looking at my report card, and he says, I don't understand this. How do you figure you're a four-point student? I says, well, you take the 2 points from the first semester, and you add it to the 2 points of the second semester.
Right, four points.
That's when he says I wasn't going to Harvard.
Right, yeah.
Next fall. Hobbit. This morning's headliner is As the
Bong,
as the bong turns.
Like the sands in the hourglass in the days of my life. This week's high five I proudly give to New England Patriots owner Robert Kraft for getting caught in a prostitution sting in Palm Beach, Florida. Imagine that, a 77-year-old billionaire having to pay for sex and then getting arrested. Talk about being my role model. Well, that sure beats his quarterback who had to sit out four games because he used deflated footballs, or his coach got fined for cheating against other teams. You know, but you got to admire an older guy who effectively used his ARP card, got the senior discount, and employing the world's oldest profession. Using President Trump's motto, buy American and make America great again, versus the other method of that guys used to have to pay for sex, like getting married.
Mm-hmm.
Elmo, Zinger.
This week's Zinger goes to lying communist schoolmarm Governor Tony Evers.
Now don't hold back.
Who promised a middle-class tax cut and during his campaign, after being handed it on a silver platter by the legislature, vetoes the thing. He says, oh, we got to find a way to pay for it. Guess what, buddy? We got a $588 million surplus. You're holding on to our cash, and it's ours. It's not yours to spend and give to the lousy road builders that financed your campaign to pay them off with bribes. So give us back our cash, you loser.
I just hate it when Elmo just holds back. You know, you got to let loose one of these times. You're ready. You got a vein in your neck. He's ready to pop. He did it all without taking a breath. You gotta love that guy.
Sure.
This week's doofus. It goes to Representative. Who is this? Is this the communist Alexandra?
AOC.
AOC. Cortez. Wacky.
Communist Barbie.
Communist Barbie. For wacky proposal of the Green New Deal, where she wants to guarantee that all Americans have a job, free college, free health care, affordable housing, and most of all, economic security, even if they're unwilling to work. To this we say, poppycock. My only question is to the communist Barbie there, what color is the sky in your world? You know, I could understand, fully understand, seriously, if this was sponsored by, say, Irish Ruth. But a representative of our United States Congress, that's a real stretch for this, so boy. And there you have it, folks, as the bong turns for this Saturday.
AOC, author of the Soylent Green New Deal, because if that goes through, we're just going to be just like the cannibals Dennis was talking about.
Well, I don't know how they're offering free money. What's the, I don't understand.
Well, the big thing is, well, you get free college, but then you don't have to work, so why bother going to college?
That's right. It's unless you're a 7-foot basketball player, you know, who can dunk and do this and wears cheap Nike shoes. Yeah, he'll probably get signed for a couple billion. We have just a couple minutes left, 2:62, 5 minutes left, if somebody wants to take a shot at stumping the chumps, or...
I think we should quit early and go do some bongs.
In Shirley's garage.
Yeah, get ready, Shirley.
Elmo, we are professional people here.
I put my pot out
there
in the garage.
You know, I was waiting for Captain Mike to call because...
his phone's broke.
He can't again?
Call, yeah, he bought that Mexican phone down there, and it broke. So,
well, you know, how am I going
to
tell him?
He wants to find somebody to pick him up at the airport in a couple of weeks. But he says, I don't know if I can get a message to figure this out. So I don't know what the heck's going to happen.
But. Well, what time is he coming in?
I have no idea.
Midnight.
Well, again, I've been at the beginning of the show. I announced that I was taken to task by the city garbage collectors because I put pizza boxes in a recyclable bag and no garbage in blue bags, so I will be very good on that thing. And I'm going to probably, nominations are being sought for Older American Award. I don't